Water. It's one of mankind's most basic needs. And demand continues to increase for this precious resource. It's an old story in the West. In the early 1900s, California bureaucrats made a secret deal to divert water, destroying Owens Lake. This created a major scandal that even became a movie starring Jack Nicholson. In response, Idaho's citizens passed laws prohibiting downstream interests from undue taking of lake water. Idaho House Bill 43 guarantees scenic beauty, health, and recreation. Today, Lake Pend Oreille is threatened again by the latest version of a federal water grab. By federal law, Albany Falls Dam's operation is mandated under Senate Document No. 9. Lake levels are to stay at normal pool for a six-month season. The plan was that ownership and control of the dam would revert to the state of Idaho as soon as the project was paid for. Many of these mandates of the day were authorized from the desk of President Harry Truman himself. But today on Lake Pend Oreille and many other western waterways, water rights are in the headlines again. The demand for more water comes from a consortium of federal agencies and power companies. Unfortunately, these demands take a heavy toll. Good things happen to a community with water at normal levels. Very bad things happen when that water goes away. Other towns have had their way of life destroyed by drawdowns, and Lake Pend Oreille is the latest under threat. Why do these agencies want to take more water? Officially, it's to help a type of char called the bull trout. So, what's really going on here? To many observers, it looks like the same old grab for Idaho's water. Only now the names have changed. Idaho's citizens have begun to fight back. By 2014, a grassroots group of business people, recreationalists, and property owners had finally had enough and sprang into action. Thousands of citizens have signed a petition to the governor and federal officials. The Save Pend Oreille Alliance is actively working to protect Idaho's water in four ways. Number one, proper dam operations. Number two, reform the MOA. Number three, get our share of mitigation funding. Number four, watchdog the Columbia River Treaty Review. This far-reaching accord is a potential game changer for all the waterways of the West. If you appreciate the rights and benefits of our waterways, including fishing, recreation, scenic beauty, navigation and property rights, and oppose outside efforts to take that water, then join the cause. Join the Save Pend Oreille Alliance with your voice and your resources. Now is the time to make your voice heard. before it's too late.